We knew that the Gestapo were monitoring our mail. Our letters had to be smuggled onto transport planes to ensure their delivery. On March 14th, I went to the airport with secret documents and witnessed an event that would have a profound effect on the rest of my life. Nicholas Winton had arranged a Kindertransport plane that was to leave from Prague and carry children as well as documents I'd brought to the airport. The parents had brought sweets and other small gifts while saying the mundane things that are usually said before parting. Be good. We'll be together soon. All the while, knowing they might not see them again.
Times were so desperate. People were very thankful if they could get their children onto the transports. I do remember at the airport, my mother was walking up and down with my sister arm in arm, rather pensively. Then also that we had our sort of last meal. And my father took photographs.
The plane was announced. As each child stepped off the exit, he or she waved to their parents, ran across the snow-covered field, waved again, and climbed aboard the plane. The parents' self-control was incredible. Smiling brightly, eyes brimming with tears, they waved back.
You know, they thought one of us might be able to escape. He was hoping to come to England.
Suddenly, the engine raced, the plane took off, and it was lost in the low clouds.
Well, my mother and the rest of my family, of course, didn't survive. They would have died in Auschwitz, yes. Well, I'd rather not go and dwell upon it, if you don't mind.